Hello. For me, photographing the Nguni was something incredibly special and humbling. Normally when we look at cows or animals in the field, one sees them as separate from you. When I was working with the Nguni, specifically this bunch of Nguni was very much working with their inner spirits, working with their inner source. They are very gentle creatures. They seem to tolerate a lot. I know that farmers talk a lot about them being very hardy, and that's probably the thing they like most about them. But when you get to work with them and when you get to talk to them, you realize that they seem to have an inner tolerance that the human race doesn't have. You know, the fact that they tolerate being shoved around, they tolerate being pushed around, told to go here, they eat this, do that, and they just seem to be incredibly obliging. They don't really answer back, and in that there is an incredible deep sense of strength. If you think of the way humans behave, we are argumentative people. We challenge, we fight. For them, they really do live in the moment. That was the greatest thing that I learned from them, working with them, was that they were quite happy with just sitting there, chewing the grass, looking around, wondering what was going to happen next. They have an inner peace that I think the human race could learn a lot from. Photographing them was quite something else. After having tick bite, after working with them, I've been on this project for about 5 months now. I've made a couple of trips up to the farms working with them. And there was always a sense of happiness and contentness when they did come around to be photographed. They would always make eye contact with a person, which I found interesting. They were very intrigued by the camera. There was one specifically after working with her, I asked her what her name was. That was the only way I could actually get to them. And she told me Mother Cow. And I remember Gordon, the farmer I was working with, he thought I was absolutely nuts talking to cows. But I think that if we just tend to take the time, and I really have been very privileged to not just be a photographer that just is worried about taking a good shot, but rather taking a photograph or capturing the essence. And I think that's really what photography should be about. We having cameras are very privileged to be able to see things and feel things that other people can't. Society is very ego-driven, and I found these animals just so peaceful. Even although they're much stronger than any human, they're bolder, they're prouder, but the courage that they showed was just absolutely phenomenal. The conditions I had to work in, I had to really wait for the right conditions. Because I'm a black and white photographer, a traditionalist still, I had to wait for clouds. So it was a matter of getting up at 5 in the morning, driving to the farm, spending time with them. And I think the important thing too is what I picked up is the importance of the farmer. The farmer's relationship to the cattle. I think that plays a huge role. Not that I know anything about farming, but just as an observer, as an outsider, noticing that, you know, the specific farmer that I worked with were incredibly gentle with the animals. They weren't just treated as cows, as an end result. I have certainly grown and learned from them that we as humans, we can certainly tolerate a lot more than we do. We are way too reactive, and we need to be gentler. And learned that in life we have a purpose here. And even if it's just to chew grass and share our inner beauty, And if people would just take the time to look at them like that, rather than just an animal, I really have great inner respect for them. And thank you. They have taught me a lot. And thank you, Nguni. Thank you for allowing me to photograph you so closely and so intimately. I really, really am privileged. Thank you.